Welcome to Late Night with the Devil here on the Radio Horror Show and the Blonde in Front of Fear, as we talk about David Dash Malchin, if I said it correctly, writer of horror stuff too, by the way. Look up Count Crowley. He is a Elvira style horror show host that turns into Kolchak the Night Stalker once the show is over. Really incredible, good. There's two series, and I have one of them signed by David as well. He does kind of a funny looking D as a signature when he does his comic books. I digress. It's through Dark Horse Comics, so go look that up. But this, in my opinion, as of April 26th, now that it's on Shudder, is my favorite horror movie of the year. This was incredible. I knew very little about this going in, other than seeing the trailer and going, oh, it takes place on a talk show. And that's the whole setting of the movie, which is great. It's the one place kind of film, you know? I love movies that can do that. The best movie that I think ever did that is 12 Angry Men. It's all in that jury room, mostly. M mostly. It's in that jury room. But this is all in this like Johnny Carson style late night 70s talk show. You got that great introduction with the voiceover, and then it's like a Halloween show. So this is like a Halloween movie that has nothing to do with Michael Myers. So you could actually watch this as Halloween time. It's one of those horror movies that takes place at Halloween, which is really nice. I love it when we can get a Halloween horror movie that doesn't have anything to do with Michael Myers, thank God. I recommend this to everybody. There wasn't a thing about this movie I hated, especially the ending. I was like, just with the audience reacting with everything that happened. Oh my God, go watch it on Shudder. Katie, what was the film fest you saw this at?
I saw this at Telluride Horror Show.
What is the Telluride Horror Show?
What?
What is that?
Telluride Horror Show is in Telluride, Colorado. It is a 4-day weekend where they show some of the best horror films in the world. And last year, Telluride Horror Show, Late Night with the Devil would have been my number one. However, it was When Evil Lurks, and that ended up be and When Evil Lurks ended up being my number one horror film of 2023. Late Night with the Devil was in my top 10, and it is a solid film. And in fact, when Late Night when I was at Telluride, David Dash Malchin was showing Late Night with the Devil at Music Box of Horrors in Chicago, Illinois, at the Music Box Theater. He was raised in Kansas City area, and I've met him before at different cons, and then he moved up to Chicago. So Chicago has, a love in his heart. He's got a love in his heart for Chicago. We have a lot in common. He's a horror guy. In fact, in Late Night with the Devil, when they're talking about you've got the narrator who immediately, when you see this movie, guys, well, as soon as you hear the narrator, you're gonna know who that is. You know horror. If you don't, it's Michael Ironside, who has done 18 jillion movies, every single, some of the best horror, some of the best action, some of just the best films in general. So when you hear him narrating, it's like, oh shit, this is real. Okay, we've got a movie
Scares.
in here.
Oh.
Yeah. And then you've got Dash Malchin. If you don't know David Dash Malchin, one, you're hiding under a rock, because he has been in actually some of the best horror, like some of the best films ever. He's worked with Denis Villeneuve. He's worked with some Ridley Scott. I mean, the list of directors that he's worked with
James
is just,
Gunn recently.
yeah, Christopher Nolan. I mean, he's a huge, he and James Gunn are friends. They've done films, many films together. And
And he'll be
he
coming back to work with James Gunn in the Creature Commandos,
also, oh, and he
the animated
also,
thing.
like any film that he's in, to me, he makes it better, no matter how big or small the part is. Like he was in a number of films last year that it's like he was the best part of the film, even if he was only in one scene. And that says that's a testament to just who he is as an actor. He's usually had like character actor roles or smaller supporting things. So I love the fact that he's been able to showcase who he is as a lead actor, because that's who he is. Like, he is a phenomenal actor that needs to get more lead actor status roles. And also, he's a great director. If you don't know the directing that he's done, check that out on IMDb. But Jack Delroy, the character that he plays, He does a little shout out to Berwyn, Illinois, where he's on his first day as the talk show host. He says, "I want to wave to my parents in Berwyn, Illinois." Many of you people won't know what that is, but that is the home base for Svengoolie, who is on MeTV, who is a huge horror host, which Dash Motion wants to do. And he also has, I think, a new show called Grave Encounters, where people are in, he's in a coffin and they're in a coffin, and then he talks to them about different things. I've only seen a little bit of it, but I think whatever he does is going to turn to gold. You get the I love how they have that feel of like his trials and tribulations, Jack Delroy, in the beginning of the movie. You know, he's got some highs, he's also got some lows. It's like 6 years since he got his show, and this night that we're seeing is the pinnacle. This is like the make it or break it for Night Owls, the late night talk show that he has. It's up against Johnny Carson. As Chris said, it's on Halloween. They've got some Halloween guests going on. They've got Christu, who's a mind reader. They've got this Carmichael Haig, who is a skeptic and sort of a hypnotist. And then they have Dr. June Ross Mitchell and Lily, who she's June Ross Mitchell has talked about the possession of this girl. Each character and each segment that he does gets more and more intense, especially with Christu, who, you know, I love how they do this in the 70s where people are like, do I have this name? Is it this? It's like, no. And then it completely blows them away. And then it's like you realize there's someone that was a plant in the crowd, or they did something that was kind of shady. But then Christu actually does have the gift, and you find out what happens to him, and it's not pretty at all. And some of it happens in the face of the audience. With Carmichael Haig, kudos to them for having a guy who's just a dick 24/7. I mean, he comes out being an ass, he leaves at the end being an ass. And wow, it takes a true actor to commit to that. I mean, at no point did you think this guy was at any at all good. But the main performance that I thought was actually best was the performance, not well, besides David Dastmalchian, was the performance of Lily, played by Ingrid Torelli. She's a little girl who was raised in a cult. She was saved. She was saved by this doctor, but there's definitely some evil presence in her. They do a seance thing to like show like who this Mr. Riggles is, that like riggles inside her brain and tells her things. And they do that on live TV. Ratings go skyrocket, but everyone in the cast and crew are like, you know what? We should get out of here. Something's wrong. There's also Jack's sidekick, who, nice guy, all that stuff. But at some point, for me, I don't know about you, Chris, he sort of felt like odd that he was there, because it seemed like usually with Johnny Carson and all those guys that have you know, the sidekick with them, or you know, they're kind of co-host people, it seems like they're friends. And this person didn't seem like he was that friendly with Jack or something like that. I don't know. It was just an odd character. He did a fine performance, he did great, but I just thought it was sort of weird. And his character, his name is Gus, who is played by Reese Arturi. Ooh, let's get into the practical effects, because when you get into a hypnotizing thing with Gus, you there's if you heard anything about Late Night with the Devil, I'll just say one thing: worms. That's all you need to know, because once you see that, yeah, it is all over. It is gross. Some of it's a little much, but a lot of it is like, holy, what the what? Again, great job. But Lily, when she gets possessed, and as soon as she comes on stage, I mean, her freaking weird, crazy, she's got crazy eyes 24/7. And I mean, they just like stare at that's like, thank you. Thank you,
Oh, she
Jack.
talks to Jack
Thank
like
you.
she's a lover. She talks to Jack not like a child, but like a lover would or a
Yeah.
girlfriend. Really, in this creepy way, you don't want children to speak to you with
No.
emphasis on words. It's just, it makes your skin crawl. I don't know. How old's the actress who plays the little the teenager? Is she being a teenager? Is she 18?
I don't even know if she's a teen. I mean, if she is, I would say probably 16, 17, something like that. But who knows? People look young. But she does a great job of like playing just like crazy shit face. Like, And when I say crazy, I just mean her face is just like, and it just completely, you know, when you see people like talking on camera and all that stuff, but someone just like stares awkwardly into the, like just right at it. That's what she does to a T. Perfection.
Ingrid Torelli.
Yes, yeah. Ingrid Torelli. She does it great. She commits to it and good for her. But the heart and soul of this movie is David Dashmalchian. If this movie did not have him, it's not the same. It's like his earnestness that you have with there and that commitment. It's like, I believe him. It's one of those things, like he's just that type of actor that it's like, okay, you know what? Whatever you say, I'm going to go with. You seem like a good guy. You know, I want you to win and all this. It's like, this may be, and he doesn't seem like he's not trying to hurt anyone. He's not trying to, you know, to go for the bad thing. He just wants the show to succeed and he wants to succeed. Like he's had a hard year. He's had some, you know, underlying things going on. But the fact is, he's the one to watch us for. See it for production design. Kudos, chef's kiss. See it for the original music by, who is it? Glenn Richards, production design, Otello Stolfo, and costume design, Steph Hook. All of those things. Excellent, excellent, excellent. And Dashmalchian. Is it one of the best films of 2023? Yeah. I mean, 2024. Look, I saw it last year. I do think it's one of the better films of 2024 and better horror films. I would definitely say it's on Shudder now. Warning, it takes 2.5 minutes, though, until it gets to the movie when you watch it on Shudder. That's only because the production, whoever our producers are, do all their things at the beginning. 2 minutes, 2 full minutes of all that, just to let you know. It's a little frustrating, but the movie is well worth it. Go see it. If you can see it in the theater, it may still be in some. Go see it, but definitely watch it on Shudder. One of the best films of 2024.
I'm glad you brought up Svengoolie, and this was a culmination of a lot of what David is into for horror and what he has done as well. Hence why I mentioned the Count Crowley thing, because he wrote that the first series a couple years ago, and the new series just came out. So, and there's a third series coming. So this, obviously, he's got this horror host vibe and idea about him to do this. And of course, this is not a horror show, but it just happens to be kind of like a, goes from the Johnny Carson show to the Geraldo kind of like extravagant guests who are part of satanic cults and lesbian blood worshippers and all the weird stuff you saw in the 80s. Weird Al did a good parody of it on UHF, if you remember.
Yeah.
Absolutely go see this movie. It's one of the best horror movies of the year. It definitely left me with this feeling of just absolute like, oh my God, and the special effects are such a very low budget too. Hopefully it gets a bigger word of mouth. It would be great, because it definitely had a very small release after the film fest. This is going to be one of my favorite horror movies of the year, unless something dethrones it. I don't see a big lineup of stuff coming out after this right now, but I haven't looked into everything. So, but we'll be back with our review of Tarot coming up in May, and don't forget to check out the rest of the reviews here on the Radio Horror YouTube channel. The twilight is almost upon me as the sun's setting. Thank you, everybody. Go check out Katie over on her Facebook page. Send us an email if you have any questions or comments at thatradiohorror@gmail.com. And we'll be back with Tarot and other movies coming out through the summer, as the summer lineup of movies is on the verge of beginning soon.